Your grace is sufficient, and you're able, God, to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can think or ask. Father, it's according to the power that worketh within us. Lord, you are more than enough. You're able to keep us from falling. You're able to present us faultless before your presence with exceeding great joy. Oh God, you are the faithful God that keepeth covenant and mercy with them that love you, them that walk before you with all of their hearts. Father, we thank you for beginning the good work within us. And you who have begun the good work, you shall continue. He shall continue. Oh God, we thank you that you are faithful and will hold fast to our confession of faith without wavering, because you are faithful. Yes, you are faithful that promised. Faithful are you that called us, and faithful are you that will do it. Father, we thank you today for beginning the good work within us. And you who have begun the good work within us, amen, you shall continue to perform. Father, we give you the praise and the glory. Lord, you're more than mama. Glory of a Sunday. Oh, Libby, he shined. Lord, a promission, the Lamoko Rabaramashanda. Lord, Ramashanda. Lord, we celebrate you today. Hey, hey, your name has been highly exalted today. It's been lifted above every name. Hey. That at the name of Jesus, oh, that's a prevailing name, that's an honorable name. Hallelujah, that's a glorious name, that's a powerful name. That name has been highly exalted and lifted above every name in the universe. Oh, God, we thank you for the name, the use of the name. Hallelujah, whatever we ask in the name when we pray. Hey, hallelujah. Yes, Lord, you promised a response when we direct that prayer. Yes, Father, to you in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, we thank you. Yes, for demanding and commanding things to be done in that name. And you said that whenever we decree, hey, that Jesus, you said you would honor it. You would do it. We give you praise and the glory today. Greater are you that is in us. Oh God, greater are you that is in us than he that is in the world. Oh God, we thank you for great peace today. The peace of God that passes all understanding. The peace that keeps our hearts and minds in perfect peace. Lord, we can be careful for nothing, but in all things by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, we make our requests known. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keeps our hearts and keeps our minds in perfect peace through Christ Jesus. Oh, we thank him, we praise him, we exalt him. Oh, we glorify him. We give him the glory that's due his name. Oh, God, we worship you. Ah, in the beauty of holiness. Thank you. We give you praise and the glory. Oh, in the name of Jesus. Hey, how many of us healing in the name of the name? for. He wants to build you up. He wants to strengthen you. He wants to encourage you. He wants to get you past that barrier and that hindrance. Put your right hand up. At your right. There is fullness of joy. Amen. If you don't have the joy, you need to get in His presence. With joy. Yes, yes. You draw water out of the well of salvation. Amen. How many glad for Jesus tonight? Today. How many glad for Him? How many glad for it this morning? Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. How many are glad for Him this morning? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I'm going to just do something different. You know, I've kind of disappointed so many people out today. Amen. Because I was going to share something that I feel that everybody could relate to in regard to the circumstances that we experienced this past week. And so I just wanted to share something that I feel that would kind of rekindle the fire to get people back in place and get people back in position and get people back to, amen, the sincere and pure devotion and dedication, amen, that they once had, amen, for the Lord. So I just want to do this today just to honor the Lord, and I believe that God is going to bless this. Amen. And it's kind of on the, kind of in the area that we were focusing on last week, but I was inspired to do kind of like a side journey, and I'm going to talk about what kind of foundation are you building on. Amen. What kind of foundation are you building on? There's been a whole lot said this past week about, amen, church and high profile personalities, and how many of them have placed their faith in God, and many of them have gone through many different types of life's challenges. And I just wanted to kind of dovetail into that thought today. What kind of foundation are you building on? Amen. When I look at some of our faces, I can pretty well tell where we are. Amen. Scripture says the joy of the Lord should be our what? Strength. Amen. I think that anybody ought to be rejoicing and victorious and excited about the Word of God and the things of God. It ought to be, amen, God's people. But when the joy begins to wane, and when our circumstances and situations begin to prevail in a greater measure than the things of God, many times we kind of show our color, show our faces, I mean by our faces and maybe have a countenance, amen, we can kind of show that we are dealing with something that we shouldn't be letting hinder us, amen, as a believer. Amen. So I want to give you some scriptures here, and this scripture, 1 Corinthians 3:10 through 15, I'm just going to read these. I'm going to be kind of informal today. The scripture says, beginning at the third, well, this is the third chapter, 1 Corinthians 10 through 15, it says, according to the grace of God, which is given unto me as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation, and another buildeth thereon. But let every man take heed how he buildeth thereon. Amen. Take heed how he buildeth thereon. The foundation is already laid. We have the pattern that we should be following from the Word of God. And I'm going to really begin to focus very heavily today on the reason why so many believers are not walking in victory, and they have dealing with challenges and circumstances that they shouldn't be dealing with. There's a song we used to sing, what a friend we have in Jesus, all our griefs and what? Sins what? To bear. And scripture says sometimes we have to bear so much because we do not even always carry these things to God in what?
Prayer.
We are not to carry our load, our circumstances, our heaviness. We are not to carry that. Amen. We are to cast all of our cares upon Him. Scripture says, be careful for nothing, but in all things by prayer. Everybody just said prayer.
Prayer.
And I think that prayer is, I think, the most important ingredient that all of us must admit that we have at our disposal is the Word of God. Amen. Feeding on the Word, receiving the Word, meditating the Word, praying the Word, singing the Word, rejoicing in the Word. Do everything that you can with the Word, and the Word will do everything you need done. What? Amen. In your life.
Amen.
Amen. How many love the Word today?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. What prophet said that? I've eaten the Word, I've received and I've eaten it, and it has become the joy and the rejoicing of my heart. Amen. How many this morning can truthfully say the Word has become the joy and the rejoicing of your heart? Amen. We have three people. Hallelujah. So I really need to preach this morning. Amen. So I know this is the message for the hour. For other foundation, verse 11, can no man lay that is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Amen. You can't get any better than the Word. You can't do any better than the Word. Jesus is the one foundation. And the Word that He embraced and taught, amen, and commanded us to teach, that's the foundation that we are to, amen, build on. Amen. Now, if any man build upon this foundation, gold, silver, precious stone, wood, hay, stubble, amen. This is the foundation that Jesus has established. Amen. That's the foundation of gold. That's the foundation of silver, precious stone. Now, wood, hay, stubble is not a solid foundation. Amen. And we are admonished not to build upon what? Wood, hay, stubble. I got another scripture in a minute that will bring it out. Every man's work shall be made manifest, for the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire. And the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is, what kind it is, what type it is. If any man's work abide, which he hath built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. If any man's works shall be burned, he shall suffer what? Loss. But he himself shall be what? Saved. Yet so as by fire. So I don't condemn people with high profiles, many of them that confess Christ. They cannot carry the world along with what? Their salvation. Amen. And you know, they do a whole lot of things that we feel that they shouldn't do. So we don't worry about where they are in their relationships with the Lord. Because everybody's works are not going to be what? Rewarded. Amen. Some will just get in the skin of their teeth. I think that many times people can be in and out, you know, fellowship and out of fellowship. But many times, we never know what's in people's heart. We don't know at what point. Many times they do get serious and they repent and all of that. So we do know that many will get in by the skin of their teeth, although their works will not be rewarded. Amen. So know ye not that ye are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you. Amen. So we are very important possession. Scripture says we are bought with a price. And it took the price of Christ's blood, amen, to cause us to be heirs of salvation. That's the only reason why Jesus can come and make his abode and live in us and live the life that he led. Amen. Scripture says that we can walk even as he walked. The reason why we are able to live that perfect life through Christ is because that Christ abides in us today. He abides in me. He lives in me. Amen. That's the beauty of salvation. Christ comes to make his abode in your life, in your heart. Amen. Jesus and Christ, the Holy Ghost. Amen. All are living in me. Amen. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Amen. So that's good news. That's enough to get all of those wrinkles off your face and put some joy in your heart. Scripture says a merry heart doeth good like a what? Medicine, but a what? Broken spirit driveth up a bones. God living in you. Amen. Hallelujah. Under the old covenant, you had to go miles and miles and get somebody to offer up a sacrifice and get you, amen, praise, get you in the right standing with God. But now, amen, Christ is my shepherd, and he lives on the inside of me. And everything that, oh Lord, everything that a natural shepherd, the care and the love and the concern that a natural shepherd has for his sheep, then that same Holy Spirit in me, amen, looks out for me, leads and guides and, amen. When I'm down, he lifts me up.
Yeah.
Hey, hallelujah. Amen. When I'm sad, he makes me glad.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Scripture says this is the victory that overcomes even what? My faith. How many can say amen? Christ in you is the hope of glory. This is the thing that prophets and priests and kings desire to see. They look forward to the day that Christ could be in us. Amen. They desired it so bad, the Bible said they just looked forward to the time that Jesus could come into a person's life and live that God life. Oh, how many know that's a wonderful life?
Amen.
Amen. Y'all don't act, I've been excited about God being in you. Hey, hey, hallelujah. Christ in me.
Yes.
Christ in you.
Yes.
The hope of glory. Oh, how many can say amen?
Amen.
That's enough to get you, hallelujah, get you running down the aisle.
Yes.
Amen. But nobody got enough to cause you to run. Amen. That's enough to get you running, leaping over walls and running through troops. Running through troops and leaping over walls. Amen. That's enough to do it because Christ in you. How many know Christ is real big?
Amen.
Lord. Amen. He ain't no little God. Y'all kind of like he's a little small person. And your cares and your problems and your circumstances, they huge to you, I guess. But otherwise, you would be what? Shouting the victory. Saying, greater. Ooh, Lord. Greater is he. Amen. It's one thing about the sun. They don't say too much stuff like that. They talk about their what? Mountains. Hey, hallelujah. But they don't talk much about what God is in. What God is in them. Amen. I want to talk about I want to magnify what God is in me.
Amen.
Amen. Because when I do that, I don't have to be concerned about my limitations and abilities and all of the barriers and hindrances that the enemy trying to what? Throw up and to hinder me. Amen. I can do all things, amen, through Christ. I wish you would just say it quietly. If you're not excited enough to say it out loud, just say it quietly. I can do all things. Glory. So, amen. I'm waiting for things like that to become reality to me. Amen. They're real now, but I want them to be a lot more real. I can do all things. When I'm facing a battle, a trial, or something that's bigger than me, ooh, Lord, my God. Knowing that that big Jesus on the inside of me is greater than all. Oh, he that dwelleth in me, he's the one that doeth the works.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. That's enough to shout. Y'all said, Pastor, that's a fake shout. Amen. But it's turning me on. Hey, I can't sing like Rihanna. Amen. But the little melody that I can make, it just turns me on. How many can say amen? God is good. Come on, lift your hand. Hey, we're going to have a good time. I know all these people, half of them are working and doing stuff today. Amen. Just make you, amen. Hallelujah. Want to just say, well, let's all of us, let's go home. Make you want to feel that way. But I'm just going to say, greater is he. God is more than enough. Oh, amen. 78 years old. I can see him right down these aisles.